yeah. If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. The streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe there's a place out there for people like you. If you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. When your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk out on your sleeve, and if you're thing you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, like you. I've heard up there the street, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your day's down here, through, there's a place. There's a place up there for people like you. Up there for people like you. I know you're out. 'Cause there's a place up there for people like you. And lend a voice to those who cannot speak. If you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way. There's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. Your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. Thank you. get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, you, there's a place up there for people like you. Keep doing what you do, 'cause there's a place up there.
To you, you will always be my guide. As the days go by, you will see that I'm forever on your side. Changed my life and strength to help me through, because you gave your son to die for me. I give my life to you. Give my life to you.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. Unending love, amazing.
amazing grace. The Lord has promised good to me. My hope secures. He will my shield and endures. My Lord, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. Amazing grace. The earth shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear to shine. But God, who amazing grace, unending love, amazing grace.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Andrea Bellamy. I work with the Barbados Licensing Authority. I'm an officer there. And on behalf of the Honorable Sanchia Bradshaw, Minister, the Permanent Secretary, the staff of Barbados Licensing Authority, and the Ministry of Transport and Works, wishes to express condolences to the Callender family and all loved ones. This is for Faye, and this is entitled Her Journey's Just Begun. Don't think of her as gone away. Life holds so many facets, and the earth is only one. Just think of her as resting from the sorrow and the tears, a place of warmth and comfort where there are no days or years. Think how she must be wishing that we could know today how nothing but our sadness can really pass away. And think of her as living in our hearts of those that she's touched. Nothing love is ever lost, and she was loved so much. Our life, we have to hide our heartache when someone speaks your name. Here without you is the heart. You did so many things for us. Your heart was kind and true. And when we needed someone, we could always count on you. Those special years with you will live with us forever. In our hearts, we know that you will walk with us forever. Goodbyes are not forever. Goodbyes are not the end. They simply Faye, until we meet again. Thank you.
Really and truly, I came this evening to sing a song. But last week, Tuesday gone, I went singing a karaoke. And after I sang the song, the proprietor told me, you don't mind me coming to the shop, but just don't sing again. So, unfortunately, I can't serenade you all this evening with a song. Faye Callender joined the Ministry of Transport and Works in 2004, and she was assigned to the Golden Ridge Depot. I was a supervisor there then, and she was on my team. I remember my first interaction with Faye was that I was recording her name in my diary, and I spelled her name F-A-Y. And Faye told me that is not my name. And I said, wait, something wrong here. What do you mean? She said, my name don't spell like that. So she said, her name is spelled F-A-Y-E. And I said, something wrong, that can't be your name. So she said, this man here can't be right. So then she gave me her ID card, and I saw the correct spelling. And we had a blast of a laugh. And from then on, Faye and I were good friends from there. And I started calling her Faye. So that was my nickname for even my phone. And I usually have her name spelled F-A-Y-E so I can remember her. Faye was a loving person. Faye was a hard worker. Faye was an intelligent, beautiful young lady. She helped very much at the depot with everything. She planned our Christmas functions. She planned funerals. We had a lot of funerals at Golden Ridge Depot. A lot of guys have passed. She planned all of them well. She even decked us out in the shirts and stuff like that with the name tags. And we love her for that. Faye worked almost in every aspect in the ministry in terms of Golden Ridge Depot. She worked with the road. She would take up a shovel and come and say she's going to do some hot mix. She was doing drainage, and at the time she worked in the depot. And that's where she got a love for working in the office. And she told me she wanted to be a supervisor. I recall one day, Faye was on me in the depot. Just after work, we were hanging out, and my phone rang. And it was my daughter calling from overseas. She was studying. And my daughter said, she called him from WhatsApp, you know, he's going straight to the speaker. Loudly, Daddy, 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 I have something to tell you. I said, Laura, she want more money now. It wasn't money. She said, Dad, I think I'm in love. I look around and see her break it down when he going fair down, when he going rolling up laughing. Fair take the phone from me and said, oh, my, you father, you're a big girl, you can have a boyfriend now. So, oh, my, he. That lady was something else. Fair then went on. Had a granddaughter she loved very much. She spoke about her granddaughter almost every day that we spoke. She used to be very interested in my daughter well-being overseas, studying. My son here, Roger, she always asked how he's doing and always giving words of encouragement to me. She then went on to the licensing authority, and I believe she did very well there, because only this evening, when it was in my office, I was speaking to a young lady, Shanna to be precise, and she said a lot of calls were coming through to her that was supposed to go to the licensing. And she said, but this particular people are always asking for Faye all the time. They're always asking for Faye, and she wanted to know who is this Faye. And the person keeps saying, we want to speak to Faye because Faye is very nice, and Faye handled us very professionally. And she made it her business to walk across and went and met Faye. And she said yes. Just by speaking to Faye, she realized why everybody wanted to speak with Faye. She was a very nice person. And it was very sad for me in hearing the passing of Faye. She used to call almost every day. And although I remember that I gave her some money to buy some chicken wings, and this is now years that I didn't get my chicken wings, so that is one of the reasons. Our conversations we based on that many times. So one day, starting in the town after a couple of years, and I asked Faye, Faye, where is my chicken wings? She said, look at me, like, you're so far they get. I said, yeah, I see, you go along. Well, yes, the gentleman, I'm glad I got the opportunity to say a few words this afternoon on the behalf of my fallen friend Faye, and I will always remember her, and I believe all the staff at Golden Ridge Depot who worked very closely with Faye will say the same. We're really going to miss her, her granddaughter. We're really going to miss her son. I met her son and her granddaughter, and I'm very glad that I got the chance to speak this evening, and I hope that the family can find some solace. And thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for giving me the opportunity. Thank you.
You as a friend, and I have lived. it rained on your parade. Seems nobody cares about you anyway. Now you're living your life like a castaway. Search for strength inside. Is it all in vain? Cause the deeper you dig, you find more and more pain. Don't let your tomorrow be like yesterday. See, I spoke to God, I called out your name, and on your behalf, I just asked if he would be there for you.
Anything that God would not have you to do, be blessed. with a grateful heart, give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son.
The Lord has congregation to stand.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. I am sure that neither death nor life nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. In the midst of life, we are in death. From whom can we seek help? From you alone, O Lord, who by your sins are justly angered. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Lord, you know the secrets of our hearts. Shut not your ears to our praise, but spare us, O Lord. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us. O worthy and eternal judge, do not let the pains of death turn us away from you at our last hour. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Kindly be seated for the eulogy will be read by Freddie Catwill to be followed by a solo by Julianne Roach.
Good evening to the church. Faye Petronella Callender was born on the 28th of April, 1971, to Renetta Mosley and Winston Haynes. She was the eldest child of Rexy, as her mom was called. Her other siblings being Sylvia Callender and Jamel Hines. She also had three sisters from her dad, Deidre, Kay, and Keisha. She was the mother of Roshan Callender and grandmother of Renicia Norville Callender, aunt of Javier, Kalia Callender, Shania Morris, Caleb, Kaylan Hines, Rashad, Rashida, Ronica, Taishe, Timani, and six others. Faye spent her early childhood days at Grove Agricultural Station, St. George, when her mom still resided with her grandparents, Mita and Fitzgerald Callender, her aunts Sherma Brown and Fiona Ashby, and her uncle Lauriston Callender. On the first day she came home from the hospital, it was indeed a joyful occasion, except her uncle Lauriston was disappointed after being told it was a girl. Taking her into his arms, he said, "I wanted a boy to play with. Girls all the time. Anyhow, you are better than nothing." Faye opened her eyes, looked at him, and from then a special bond was formed until this very day. Faye attended St. George's Girls Primary School, then on to Spring Memorial Secondary School. At that time, she and her brother Sylvia relocated to Harleton St. Philip with their mum after she was married. However, most weekends or any chance they had, they could be found at their grandparents' home in St. George. The two of them later returned to the glebe land, number 2 St. George, to live with their grandparents and their uncle. The family worshiped at St. George Parish Church, which is where Faye was christened and confirmed. Her first job was at the then Basic Supermarket in Oisins Christchurch. She also worked at Do It Best Sheraton Mall, then the MTW station at Golden Ridge Depot. She was later transferred to the Barbados Licensing Authority, where she worked until her death. Faye was jovial, lively, patient, and a beautiful soul, and with a bright and cheeky smile always on her face. Everyone who came into contact with her usually stayed and became part of the family. Her family was her anchor, her love, and commitment to them was unquestionable. Indeed, at times it felt that she knew the whole of Barbados and that they knew her. Sometimes she was very outspoken and hated to see any injustice coming to anyone. All her friends could certainly attest to this. Her godmother, Margaret Eastman, would tell you she was such a special child. She had a selected group of children and godchildren who grew up coming to her home most Sunday evenings to get their hair plaited for school. Those same Sunday evenings, Faye could also be found in the company of Judith, Waveney, and Nadine Thornhill, and other cousins sitting and spending quality time together. She embraced life, and she remembered everyone's birthdays and anniversaries. She was always involved in planning any parties, the annual family picnic, other gatherings, and especially the back-to-school picnic in August or September for the children in the family. Gifts were also very important to her, and any exam results, when they were good, were rewarded for their efforts. Faye loved to shop, and every Saturday morning, her cousin Judith, Aunt Sherma, and Fiona would always receive a call inquiring what time to leave home. Phone calls were her specialty as well. She would call everyone to inquire about their health or just to check in on them. Sometimes when asked why she was always going into town, she would reply it was to leave the house, get out there, exercise, and to meet people. Reality was, Faye usually had a shopping list for others. Someone needed a wedding dress, a child needed a pair of shoes or socks, or a male needed a shirt or pants for a special occasion. You could ask Faye where to buy something from, and she would always tell you, check this store or that or next. If you needed a ride, she was there. And her great aunt, Lucille Braffitt, knew that bread was coming from Carter's Bakery when Faye was on her way home. Similarly, her great uncle, George Braffitt, knew that if both of them were at the same function, he would get a ride home safe and sound. All these excellent qualities were instilled in her as a child, continued to be seen in her daily life. She was one of the best, and God usually takes the good ones. Her illness was swift, silent, and shocking to many. But let not your heart be troubled, for she's in a better place, planning greater things, and meeting other people. Even though we will miss her, She will always be in our hearts. I know we will surely meet again someday. May angels lead her into paradise, and may God receive her and have mercy on her soul. Rest in sweet peace, sweet girl, rise in glory. Now, on behalf of the family, friends, workmates, and well-wishers, we truly appreciate all the little and big things you have done over the years. Those little hugs, every smile, conversations, and gestures, these made our lives complete and happy to our niece. Thank you for the prayers and encouragement. To the doctors and nurses of Ward B5 of the Queen Elizabeth Hospital, we want to say a big thank you for taking care of Faye during her time with you. To the workers of the MTW Golden Ridge Depot and the Barbados Licensing Authority, as well as the many others who took the time out to visit, sent gifts, offer prayers, we truly thank you from the bottom of our hearts. To our family members, you will always be our strongest support. Thank you for being a pillar of strength in this time. We ask that all of you continue to pray and lift us up during our time of mourning and in the future. On behalf of the Callender, Hines, Thornhill, Brathwaite, Payne's, and Haynes family, we thank you and God bless you all. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. You don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Sorrows, they don't last always. For there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. You see, you don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last always. Remember, there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. With Jesus, I can take it. With him, I know can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. You see, all your tests and trials, they seem to get you down. And all your friends and loved ones are nowhere to be found. Remember, there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand no matter what may come my way. My life is in your hands. With Jesus, I can take it. With him, I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Oh, with Jesus I can take it. With him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. I know that we can make it. I know that we with him we know we can stand. No matter what, no matter what may come our way, our lives are in his hands. Oh, our lives are in his hands. You gotta believe that. Our lives are in his hands. We've been made joy for a night, but joy comes in the morning.
That's fine. Kindly stand for the singing of hymn 480.
break, O God, whose mercies cannot be numbered. Accept our prayers on behalf of your servant, Faye Petronella, and grant her an entrance into the land of light and joy, the fellowship of your saints, through Jesus Christ, O Lord, who lives and reigns with you and of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
To be read by the feet of Martin.
Good evening. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 35 to 39. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress, or persecution or famine, or nakedness or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Can you please sing it as a choir chant, Psalm 23.
Good evening. A reading from the Revelation to John, chapter 21, verses 1 to 7. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth has passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I made all things new." Also, he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children." The word of the Lord.
The hymn 497.
And the Reverend Suzette Archer, who could not be here this afternoon, to join with the family in praising Almighty God for the life, love, and witness that they would have received amongst them in the form of our sister Faye. I've also been asked to convey condolences on behalf of the High Commissioner to Canada, familiarly known to us as Minister Glenn Clark. He remembers the family and wishes you to remember that he upholds you in his prayers. I wish us to reflect as we give God thanks on the 35th verse of the 8th chapter of Romans. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Yesterday, as the world celebrated Valentine's Day, Christians around the world would have celebrated Ash Wednesday. And for that occasion, I put pen to paper and crafted a little ditty. I know it will win no Nobel Prizes, it will win no literary awards, but I want to share it, shared with the congregation of St. Augustine last night. And we are all familiar with the first two lines at least. Roses are red. By the way, I did not know red was the color this evening. Roses are red, violets are blue. Despite the lives that we have led, God's love is steadfast, faithful, and true. Roses are red, violets are blue. Despite the lives that you and I have led, God's love, steadfast, constant, faithful, and true. It is on that bedrock that the entire Christian faith rests. It is so integral to our faith that John the Elder would have penned these very simple words: God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God. And oftentimes when it comes to a funeral, I have to do a little two-step in the pulpit. I have to pray before going in that God will understand what I'm about to do. And I have to try to make something out of interesting lives. And I'm always grateful when I am invited to participate in a remembrance of someone whose life truly reflected what it is to be rooted and grounded in God's love. You heard the eulogist earlier. Our sister was one who was loving and generous. She was one for whom justice, righteousness, was a pinnacle and a cornerstone of her life. There's only one reason somebody would go into town these days and shop for somebody else. You can't pay me to do it. Such was the character of our sister Faye. Her life was such that she was not perfect by any means, but she sought to live a good and a godly life. And that is why this evening, even as we mourn, even as we sorrow, we can indeed thank Almighty God. Because she took on board the lessons of her youth. Lessons that should have gleamed here in Sunday school and that would have rooted her and carried her throughout life. That she serves a God of love. And I want to remind us who are gathered here this evening, the family members who mourn, whose hearts are burning. There are some of you, I am sure, who are not as well rooted as you ought to be in the faith of Almighty God. Don't worry about that. Because remember the ditty, despite the lives we have led, God still loves us. God still seeks to hold us up, to comfort us in the midst of our sorrow. Reminded us, joy will come in the morrow. And that is because God loves us. And so he seeks the very best for his children. He seeks only our good. And so even as we may have questions about her illness, because the eulogists try to make it seem all good, but I know some of them are saying she was a good one. I know many who would have gone along and left her here. Turn to Almighty God. He is the one who has declared that he is our God. And we who remain faithful to him, despite the ups and downs, the griefs and the sorrows of life, if we remain faithful to him, we shall be his people. I have said it over and over again, God never abandons any one of his children. We abandon him. God always says to us, come unto me, ye who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. We turn away. Do not turn away from Almighty God. Do not let the pains of your sorrows imprint in your mind that you are alone. You are never alone. God, the one who loves us beyond all measure. That is what St. Paul was trying to get the congregation in Rome to understand. Despite persecutions, despite hardship, what is there on earth? And Paul goes through the gambit. He asks us, can death, can life with its uncertainties, can things present, things past, things to come, can anything in creation separate us? And the answer is a resounding, oh no, not one thing. Not one thing can separate us from God's love. A love that embraces us. We are well aware of human frailty. We are well aware of what we call fair weather friends. They're the friends that things need to be going smoothly for them to be in your life. But the minute something goes wrong, you better not waste your time calling. When you are in pain, they're going to spin. Can't find them. God, and especially the young ones, I want you to hear me. Your Creator is always there. You need not hide anything from him. And if we wish to truly honor our sister Faye's memory, I want to encourage you to do two things. First is this, put God first. Put God first, and all other things will be added unto you. Do not seek after wealth, after status, popularity. Seek God. And the things that you need, the things that will lift you up, he will provide in abundance beyond your greatest imagination. The second thing to all of us gathered here is this. Our sister Faye was generous to a fault. We heard the eulogist say she could not abide by unfairness. It grieved her. I want to encourage, first and foremost, the family. Secondly, the friends and co-workers and all those who knew her. Follow in Faye's example. How much better would our world be if more persons were grieved by injustice and grieved to the point where they did something about it, and not just tweet about it, by the way, not just post pictures on social media, but sought to right wrongs, to give a voice to those whose voice would be taken away. To stand up and say, you cannot unfair so-and-so, not as long as I'm present. How many of us are willing to join in that legacy? to ensure that once again the Bradford and the Thornhill and the Cox and the Payne and the Haynes clan are known as a people who produce people who are lovers of justice, who are a lover of humanity. Do not let her witness go down to the dust with her. There is nothing sadder to me that you have someone who lived a good life, a commendable life, and then a few years later on, no one else in the family circle has taken up the mantle to follow in their example. The goodness they have done has gone down to the ground with them. The mercy that they showed went with them. Let it not be said of any of us here gathered. If we are truly here gathered this afternoon to honor Faye, to give God thanks and praise for her, we do not need words. Our lives need to reflect it. That is what it means to recognize God's loving nature. We seek to respond to it in our own lives. Can we commit ourselves to honoring our sister Faye? Are we going to think about it? People say to me, you got to think about it. That's all right. It's better to think about it than going to say yes, no, and then can't do it. But I really want to encourage us. When we proclaim that not one thing can separate us from the love of God, the unspoken truth is this. Then we wish to respond to that love, just as our sister Faye did in her lifetime. It may have seemed short to us, but she left her mark. In a little while, you will hear me say the words, the record of her deeds have gone before her. You and I who are left, who remain, will our record be even greater than our sister's Faye? Or will we let the love of God go down to the dust? Let us pray. Gracious Father, you are a loving God who cares for all your children, who never abandons us, not even in the hour of our sorrow. This evening, as we give you thanks, and as we praise you for our sister Faye, we also ask for your strength in our life. We ask for your guidance, that we, like her, may honor you with our life, every day and every moment given to us, until the day we can meet you face to face. We ask in the name of Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and our Redeemer. Amen. My brothers and sisters in Christ, I invite us now to stand. I invite us to stand, and with boldness, with confidence, and with hope, let us confess the faith that would have undergirded our sister Faye's life and would have directed her at all times. As we say together the Apostles' Creed, to be found on page 6, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son.
The prayers. We pray for those who mourn, especially the grieving family members. We commemorate the party Faye Petronella. We commend your response after each petition is hear our prayer. Let us pray with confidence to the God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life, which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy, be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy, may we be strengthened in our faith, live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy, show your mercy to the dying. Strengthen them with hope and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy, we commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister Faye, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen.
The hymn 496. And during the singing of this hymn, a collection will be taken towards the upkeep of the churchyard.
Thank you. things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. And all of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life. Things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet come true. All of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through, use it for your glory. Praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life. Lord, I offer you my life.
Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, "Write this. Happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds." In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, O Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister, and we commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister Faye Petronella, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, with whom still lives the spirit of those who died in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord. May she and all the faithful departed, through the tender mercy of God, rest in peace. And may the Lord bless her and keep her. May the Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious unto her. May he lift up the light of his countenance upon her and grant to her eternal peace. Amen.
The hymn, "When Peace Like a River Attendeth My Way."
When peace like
I journey through the land, singing as I go, pointing souls to Calvary, to the crimson flow.
Thank you.
the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more. Again.
Leave this place protected. Smite death's threatening way before. things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. And all of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Everything I've been through, use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life. Sacrifice, Lord, I offer you my
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Remember, O Lord, this your servant, Faye Petronella, who has gone before to the sign of faith and now rests in the sleep of peace. According to your promises, grant to her and to all who rest in Christ refreshment, light, and peace. Through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest and remain with you and be a source of comfort and consolation this night and forevermore. Amen.
we go.
It's to our God.
It's to our God.
Every word of worship.
Every word of worship.
With one accord.
With one accord.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
It's to our God.
It's to our God.
Come on, everybody. Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
To our God.
To our God.
Glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
It's to our God.
To our God.
Come on, say every praise.
Every praise.
Say every praise.
It's to our God.
Y'all know how we do it. Take it up, every praise.
It's to our God.
Every word of worship. With one accord. Come on, say every praise.
Every praise.
It's to our God. I want everybody all over the world to sing hallelujah. To our God.
It's to our God.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
It's to our God. Let's take it up one more time. Every praise.
Every praise.
Come on, everybody.
It's to our God.
Every word of worship.
Every word of worship.
With one accord.
With one accord.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.